We welcome all to St. Mary's today as we celebrate the 16th Sunday in Ordinary Time. The announcements for this weekend include: our drive-through picnic is next Sunday from noon to 4 p.m. Pre-sale chicken orders must be placed by today at 11 p.m. A limited number of dinners will be available on the day of the picnic. The drive-through includes balloons, bubbles, pick a prize, music, and food. Bring your singles to spend. Parking for Mass next Sunday, July 26th, will be limited. Parishioners coming for Sunday Masses should use the side parking lot, the rectory parking lot, and the Swarmville Fire Department lot only. The back parking lot and Transit Road lot will be used for the drive-through picnic that day. Signs will be posted to assist parishioners. Don't forget to turn in your raffle tickets for a chance to win cash prizes, including a grand prize of $10,000.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today we are blessed again at this Mass because we have four first communicants. And I'm going to call them forward so we can all get a good look. And we're even going to hear them introduce themselves for us, because I'm a coward. And I was telling some of them I was a teacher and a principal, and for us, there's nothing worse than mispronouncing a name, a last name. And I still get nervous. So this time I'm going to take this off. Watch this. I'm going to hold it in front of them, and they can take it and hold it and tell us their name. So, four first communicants, please come forward and stand right here on the top in any order you'd like. Stand up there. Let everyone in the church see you. And there's all kinds of people who are also watching this at home. And then it'll be kept on the YouTube page for the, so people all over the world will see this, which is what makes me nervous. But don't you get nervous. Joseph, are you ready to introduce yourself?
Yep. Hello, I am Joseph Pavlovich.
Excellent. Tell us something about yourself.
My favorite color is red.
Excellent. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Jacqueline, and I play baseball in the Diamondbacks.
Ooh, excellent. And you know what I can help notice? You never told us your last name. Are you choosing not to? Or would you like to introduce yourself again?
Hi, I'm Jack Nikolczyk, and I play baseball in the Diamondbacks.
That's beautiful. Thank you. Luke, I am not your father, but I want you to introduce yourself.
Hi, my name's Luke Finari, and I play golf.
Really? Excellent. Well, if you become very good at it, remember St. Mary Church in Swarmville. Peyton, you're going to introduce yourself, your full name, and then look at the camera and tell us something about yourself.
Hi, my name is Peyton Sadrowski, and I dance.
Wow. So we've got a dancer, a golfer, a baseball player, and a man who likes the color red. Yeah. Wait, they can't hear you.
I'm also a baseball player that plays on the same team as her.
Oh, teammates, very nice.
Yep.
Boy, times have changed since I was a kid. That's wonderful. Well, listen, I already told them, so I'm warning everyone else, the first communicants are going to be the first to receive communion today. So if you see any adult, just kind of nudge them out of the way, because I want to see you four come up first. All right? Does anyone else have anything else to say? Now's your chance. You want to do this again after communion? I'm just kidding. People have masks on. I can feel the vibes already. Just keep going. All right. Thank you. Go back to your families, and we'll see you at communion time. We're going to get the phone calls, Deacon Rick.
I know it. I'm going to get the phone calls.
You passed them on very well, though, the message. We're all sinners, but God loves us all. So let's take a moment, acknowledge that, and ask the Lord for mercy and strength.
Lord Jesus, you are the living Word, calling us to embrace goodness and truth. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the searcher of hearts, calling us to life of love for one another. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Redeemer, calling us to pattern our lives on the mystery of your death and resurrection. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. There is no God besides you who have the care of all, that you need show you have not unjustly condemned. For your might is the source of justice. Your mastery over all things makes you lenient to all. For you show your might when the perfection of your power is disbelieved. And in those who know you, you rebuke temerity. And though you are a master of might, you judge with clemency. And with much lenience you govern us. For power, whenever you will, attends you. And you taught your people by these deeds that those who are just must be kind. And you gave your children good ground for hope, that you would permit repentance for their sins. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings. And the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
My sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus proposed another parable to the crowd, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a man who sowed good seed in his field. While everyone was asleep, his enemy came and sowed weeds all through the wheat and then went off. When the crop grew and bore fruit, the weeds appeared as well. The slaves of the householder came to him and said, 'Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where have the weeds come from?' He answered, 'An enemy has done this.' The slaves said to him, 'Do you want us to go and pull them up?' He replied, 'No. If you pull up the weeds, you might uproot the wheat along with them. Let them grow together until harvest. Then at harvest time I will say to the harvesters, First collect the weeds and tie them in bundles for burning, but gather the wheat into my barn.' He proposed another parable to them. 'The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that a person took and sowed in a field. It is the smallest of all seeds, yet when full grown, it is the largest of plants. It becomes a large bush, and the birds of the sky come and dwell in its branches.' He spoke to them another parable. 'The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed with 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch was leavened.' All these things Jesus spoke to the crowds in parables. He spoke to them only in parables to fulfill what had been said through the prophet, 'I will open my mouth in parables. I will announce what has laid hidden from the foundation of the world.' Then dismissing the crowds, he went into the house. His disciples approached him and said, 'Explain to us the parable of the weeds in the field.' He said in reply, He who sows good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, the good seed the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one. The enemy who sows them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the harvesters are angels. Just as weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all who cause others to sin and all evildoers. They will throw them into the fiery furnace where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Whoever has ears ought to hear. The Gospel of the Lord. As I was preparing for my homily today, I found a homily online that was preached by a deacon in New Jersey. He discussed the theory of the butterfly. Now, you might have heard about this theory and said it's garbage science, but it goes something like this. The movement of the wings of a butterfly can affect change in the world, like causing a tropical storm to grow into a Cat 5 hurricane. Rubbish, right? But this is what the gospel parables that Jesus tells us alludes to. The little things we do can make a difference. So hold on to that thought. What is your perception about the kingdom of God? I'm sure most of us consider the kingdom of God to be heaven. But have you considered the possibility that the kingdom is really here on earth, that it is among us? This is where the wheat and the weeds parable comes in. The kingdom is all around us. But are you the wheat or the weeds? Are you the good influence or the bad? How do your actions influence others, good wheat or bad weeds? Do you judge others the same as the workers judge the weeds? Let's just pull them out and throw them away because these people are different or needy or have different views. They don't think like me, so throw them out. Well, this environment we live in today, that we all live in today, is one of my way or the highway. We no longer want to have discussions about opposing viewpoints. We would rather argue and insult each other instead of working toward a solution to the challenge or to reach a common goal. No, we just want to fight amongst ourselves and continue to be divisive. We're told in the Book of Wisdom that we should care about everyone and not unjustly condemn. That's what we need to show lenience, be kind, and promote hope in the face of adversity. This is where the butterfly theory comes in. That tiny seed you plant in someone's mind about the unborn, instead of railing on them, will go farther in converting that person. Or showing your children visiting from out of town that going to church on Sunday is important to you, more important than at tea time with your son-in-law. Why not try inviting them to come along? That seed might just get them back here to Sunday Mass. The tiniest of seeds, that mustard seed, produces a large bush. You planting that tiny seed may have a profound effect on someone, and you may never even know it. Showing compassion to a co-worker going through a tough time, even though they tend to be a real pain most of the time, goes a long way in helping that person feel wanted. And they may just pay it forward to someone else. That's the butterfly theory in action. What you do to someone may affect another person you may never even know, just because you made a positive difference in someone's life. Yet the reality of today is not one of tolerance or compassion or forgiveness. The culture of today is to vilify, condemn, seek retribution, destroy what is not yours just because you can. The lack of Jesus in our homes, the lack of prayer in our homes, the lack of true Christian values being taught in our homes could be the weeds that are sown among us. The devil and his followers have an insidious way of getting the wheat to follow. It's like baiting children with candy. Remember the end of the parable of the man who sowed the good seed? Those who cause a little one, a child of God, to sin will be dealt with severely at the end of time. The weeds will be gathered and burned, and the wheat will be gathered into the barn of eternal life with God. Again, this is where the butterfly theory comes into play. Remember how the householder told his workers not to pull up the weeds because they might also pull up the wheat? You, as the wheat in the world, can affect other people who are also wheat but are being choked by the weeds. Those others may be the ones who are not strong in their faith and are being influenced by the secular world in the wrong way, or are being influenced to be a part of the my way or highway culture. The ones who are being influenced by others in authority who are leading them on the path to self-destruction and ultimately the destruction of the values we as Christians hold near and dear to our hearts. Be that butterfly. Speak up when you see someone who needs guidance because of the sway of the devil and his followers. Who knows? Your wings might just be the heart, might just turn the heart of someone in need of a positive influence to come back to Jesus and pay it forward, influencing others. So, which are you, the wheat or the weeds? And how will your butterfly wings affect the world? God bless.
Let us stand and together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With great trust in our God of love, we now present the Lord with our needs.
The response today is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that we will continue to establish and strengthen the kingdom of God in a world of suffering from poverty and injustice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who lead us in government, that they will work to create profound respect for the dignity of human life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the coronavirus pandemic, that God's healing love will drive the virus away from the human family and inspire all who are working on treatments and vaccines to successful conclusions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are bound by hatred and resentment, that the Spirit will cultivate forgiveness and compassion within hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For educational leaders, that God will give them insight and courage as they work to plan for the coming school year so that students may learn and everyone stays safe and healthy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for the children who are receiving the Eucharist for the first time this weekend, that they will remain close to Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the ill and hospitalized, especially Tom Janik, Debbie Mishnick, and Cheryl Rossi, that they will soon know healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the recently deceased, that they will be granted eternal rest in heaven, including the Most Reverend Edward Kimmick, Bishop Emeritus of Buffalo, Allison Knapp, Gerald Natopsky, and for Janice Morawski, for whom this Mass is offered. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, we offer these prayers with great trust, for we make them all in the name of your Son, Jesus, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy, as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us now offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace, Father.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I want to congratulate again Joseph and Jacqueline and Luke and Peyton. You received communion beautifully today, and Jesus is delighted that his life and body and blood are joined to yours now. Stay close to him in the Eucharist by receiving communion your entire life. So welcome again to the table of the Lord's banquet. Let us stand and pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I'm going directly into the reconciliation room if anyone would like to go to confession after Mass. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Let us go in peace, fluttering our wings.
Thanks be to God. Good job.